I am not a liar. I have killed thousands. I have fed more drug fiends than the top three pharmaceutical companies combined. I have stolen children from parents, wives from husbands, wiped out entire generations. But lying, that I have never done. The rest are offenses against humanity. Lying is an offense against yourself. I am the head of the Santa Blanca organization, which you call a cartel. I had a dream. I dreamed of a land where we could grow our own coca, produce our own cocaine, where we could run our business free from interference from the police, the government, the army, the Yankees. In my dream, a woman's voice asked me,
"Sueño, mijo, what if you had your own country?"
Like Moses, I led my people to the promised land, Bolivia. We came here. We bought the coca fields. What we couldn't buy, we took. We bought the police, the military, the judges, the politicians. We were on the verge of becoming the government itself. On the razor's edge from fulfilling my dream. Of creating a narco-state. The nation of Santa Blanca.
Last week, a crude explosive detonated outside the U.S. Embassy in La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian Special Forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the US and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece. The cartel is organized into four operations: production, smuggling, security, and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses, El Sueño.
Hola de nuevo, soy Ajaxins. Tal y como visteis, bueno, ya si seguís el canal, hace un tiempo subí la beta cerrada porque me apunté a la beta cerrada de Ghost Recon Wildlands y tenía muy claro ya de entrada que me lo iba a comprar y más después de jugar a la beta. Y bueno, me ha llegado hoy, hace nada. Por suerte no ha tardado mucho y el parche de día 1 no es que fuera muy grande, que suelen ser bastante grandotes. Y bueno, aquí tenéis los primeros 50 minutos, no sé si voy a cortar mucho o qué, pero bueno. Bueno, se ve más o menos igual que la beta gráficamente, es ridículo esperar ningún cambio gráfico con tan poco tiempo. Pero bueno, realmente estoy seguro de que lo voy a disfrutar. Sí que me ha parecido un poco más agradable en general de jugar que la beta. Ya veremos cómo va el tema del online. Hace un tiempo tuve algún que otro problema con mi router. Ahora en principio debería funcionar bien. Por algún motivo me sigue diciendo que tengo NAT estricta cuando debería poner NAT abierta. Se supone que tengo los puertos abiertos, pero bueno. Y bueno, este finde voy a jugar más. Hoy entre semana no me da tiempo para más porque he querido probarlo hoy que llegaba, pero ahora tengo que currar un rato. Y bueno. Pues nada, este sí que es uno de esos que voy a intentar subir entero. Y por lo que veo tengo juego para rato, pero con la beta ya estuve bastante tiempo y solo estuve en una de las provincias. La beta abierta no la jugué porque como al acabar la cerrada ya tenía muy claro que me iba a comprar el juego definitivo, pues me dije volver a empezar y al final pensé, hostia, acabarás cansado. Y prefiero entrar lo más fresco posible al juego definitivo. Y bueno, esta es la segunda vez que hago Itaqua. La primera vez recuerdo que me salté la historia porque lo que quería era ver cómo era la jugabilidad y porque en ningún momento he pensado que una historia de un juego de un shooter pueda ser especialmente interesante. Pero bueno, dentro de todo me ha sorprendido ahora que la he escuchado. Es bastante interesante dentro de lo que cabe. Y bueno, en este solo hay creo que una misión, pero de hecho es que con todo el trozo este de hacer la personalización del personaje y todo el rollo de la historia, pues ha chupado bastante más tiempo y no tengo mucho más tiempo hoy para jugar. Pero bueno, ha salido bastante mejor que en la beta, si no recuerdo mal. Bueno, en la beta fui bastante a saco y aún no controlaba mucho, pero bueno. Y bueno, como lo habéis visto al acabar, me he equipado el francotirador. Mi intención es ir con metralleta y francotirador. Me lo pasé muy bien haciendo de franco en la beta. Algo que solo he conseguido en los Ghost, en el Future Soldier me lo pasé muy bien y en este también. En otros juegos puede que realmente pueda ser muy divertido ir con el francotirador, pero solo con este realmente me lo he llegado a pasar bien. Y nada, esto sí, si todo va bien este finde, lo que suba de este juego va a ser con mi amigo de la Xbox, el con el que jugué en la beta. Y bueno. Vamos a completarlo entre los dos. En principio, habrá algún capítulo, evidentemente, que juego yo solo, porque coincidir siempre no es fácil. Pero bueno, nada más que decir, no me enrollo más. Solo decir, estoy muy contento con poderlo jugar por fin y espero que disfrutéis tanto como yo.
Thank you. The agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Guess you've been down here a while?
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper.
How'd you get in country? I flew in business class from Manaus. Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ass.
I've heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
You should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño. He's got a religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, and JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pak Qatari, soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Soldiers. This is the help you promised, that Sandoval promised. A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pak Qatari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru is one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, our group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he is in this province and that there is a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pat Katari and these rebels. They're kind of ideal. Always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and the firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find Amaru.
Of course not. The Lord said, "Inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of these, my brethren, ye have done it unto me." Santa Blanca believes this, and as an agent of good, Santa Blanca knows that we can create the world that we all wish to live in. Giving works, and Santa Blanca gives to Bolivia.
PSYOP unit down here, don't you think? Or MISO, or whatever they're called now.
Shit, there might be one here already for all we know. Bowman plays her cards close to the chest.
You don't think Bowman's got other operators out here?
You think the activity's just a bunch of chairborne rangers? They might not be throwing lead, but somebody else is out here. Don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors.
Deploying drone. Got another tango. Just spotted one with submachine.
Got eyes on the target. Let's move.
Getting a position.
ready to fire. Enemy down.
Hostile down. We'll leave a marker so the rebels can pick up the supplies later.
Say the word. I got a Sicario over here. There, in the watchtower.
Pinche vato culero.
That's one down.
Coopere todo saldrá bien.
Pinche cabrón.
Está bien, me rindo.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. ¿Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you!
Está bien, ganaron.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead.
Maybe, maybe not. Amaru's a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move. Let's get moving. The cartel isn't gonna wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
Good to go.
Buckle up, people.
Citizen and the nation is through a free economy.
Hostiles in the area, stay frosty. Two Sicarios. Over, about... the barn.
I got a third. That makes five. Marking a tango. He's close to that local. Target marked. Keep an eye on your background.
Tengo mucho sueño y falta un chingo aún.
Coming up on a Toyo farm. Remember, a lot of these Sicarios are ex-military.
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go. Tango down.
Cultivate the good in benevolent power from your heart, so that it will not be evil, but keep that evil out.
okay, we're still good.
Just as God gave Lucifer his kingdom, let your evil reign in its place.
Drone is airborne.
Ready. Call the shot.
That's a kill.
They're on alert. We're good. We're good.
Alguien ayúdeme a salir de aquí.
Están aquí. Carajo, nos están atacando. Cúbranse.
They know we're here.
Sé que alguien me escucha, cabrones. Sé que están ahí. Así que escuchen bien. Dios nos perdona.
Estamos de espera. Responde. A partir de la madre con todo. Vamos a enseñarles quién manda. ¡Disparen!
Assholes are coming this way. What's the plan?
¿Qué pensará mi familia? ¿Se acordará de mí?
¿Creerán que he muerto?
Están esperando, cabrones.
Boom, target down.
Firing. We're clear over here. God, these fuckers are sloppy.
The rebels is nothing less than a battle.
Enemy activity, stay sharp.
Freedom of Bolivia. The government supported foreign investment has done much to improve the lives of the Americans.
Ayúdenos, por favor.
Are you Amaru?
What's left of him anyway?
Come on, we're getting you out of here. Yo, I got a weapons case here. Nice.
And with each other. But we want the harmony of a free society, not the order of slavery.
¿Qué tal? ¿Todo bien?
There are a lot of lights and switches up here.
Where are you taking me?
Back to your friends.
Entonces Pacatari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros, the young fool.
Take it up with him, senor.
it. Hold up. There's a weapons case here.
Hey, come on down.
This will go nice with my boots.
Are you hurt?
Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Sí, Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe 4. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock. Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through.
There were 4 people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last 2 were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchón named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were 4 people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
That's the rundown on La Yuri and El Polito. They're a key part of Santa Blanca's security operation. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
Guy in charge of security is El Muro, the Wall, personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño. El Muro's little brother is La Plaga, nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up the hierarchy. First targets are Yuri and Polito. We find the intel, we track them down, we take them out.